You've landed on Nar Shaddaa. Few on that world will be pleased to see you, I'm afraid. Nar Shaddaa is a den of corruption, excess, and gang violence. It is ruled by a crime syndicate, the Hutt Cartel, that takes a cut from every black deed.
Nar Shaddaa must have been a lawful place once?
At best, it was a refugee camp for the Ivakai, the original natives, until the Hutts imposed their heavy industry there. But now, despite its power, the Hutt Cartel is clashing with a new group called the Guiding Hand. The Guiding Hand's followers are fanatically loyal to an unknown leader. I believe this leader is Duras Fane, one of the missing Jedi Masters.
Is there evidence suggesting Master Fane is involved?
Fane is an undisciplined maverick, but he has great charisma, incredible skill at influencing others through the Force. This Guiding Hand has attacked Cartel spice shipments, operations Fane despises, in a way that shouts Fane's tactics. It's him. I know it.
I'll find him, Master. Hopefully he'll be cooperative.
Fane has flirted with darkness for years. The plague may have finally tipped the balance. Even fighting the Guiding Hand, the Cartel is immensely powerful, second only to the Republic and the Empire. So far, the Hutt Cartel has tolerated, even aided the Republic. But if it discovers a rogue Jedi is hurting business...
We'd lose the Cartel's trade routes, information, and credits.
We must find Fane before the Hutt Cartel discovers his involvement. I have a contact on Nar Shaddaa who can help you, named Theron Cedrex. Theron is a professor of exotechnology. He was once a friend of mine, and of Fane's.
How do I find this Theron Cedrex?
Theron has offices on Nar Shaddaa's promenade. He's usually there, if he's not nurturing his genius in a casino. Good luck. And don't underestimate Duras Fane, Jedi. His gifts of persuasion are unsurpassed.
Welcome to the offices of Dr. Theron Cedrex. My name is Holiday, and I'm pleased to assist you. If you have an appointment, please make yourself comfortable while... Oh my goodness. It's rare to greet such a distinguished customer. I'd save your picture to my permanent drive, but that might upset my dear Theron.
Are you some sort of projection? Or a droid?
No. I'm more than that. Much more. I'm a fully sentient holographic life form. Unique in the galaxy. Or so Theron says. You're a Jedi, aren't you? If you're here to see Theron, he's... Well, I've been waiting for him to get back. For hours and hours.
Did he tell you where he was going?
Theron had a special order to design a weapon, and the customer wanted him to deliver the prototype to the Nikto sector. The aliens there hate humans. The Republic. Hygiene. He should never have agreed to go.
Give me directions and I'll bring him home safely for you, Holiday.
I promise. I'll be ever so grateful if you do. The meeting place is in the Nikto sector's starship chop shop. It sounds like a nasty place. Please be careful.
Don't be an imbecile. The weapon's obviously my creation. If you use it against the Hutt Cartel, I'll be looking for my vertebrae in a trash compactor. Deal's off.
Manchi doti puna puna. Kabuk nunis nemo.
You won't serve your master by getting angry.
Chobot I kafstuan bile jihulokuta.
I'm begging you, please don't get him started on this again.
O granitampio da pushi wumpa, pu tula musta.
Who is this master you keep talking about? What's his name?
Kunhuka taba tata kipuna. Kabano tase ma kipuna. Mali tuta udmishka.
I want to stop the darkness too. Let me join you and learn at your master's feet.
Ukili mo klunki. Nik mi chawa welmo.
Most Nikto are only worthy to kiss up to huts. It seems like you can't even do that anymore.
Wonki atacha kapa tonka. Jisa picha.
That was gratifying. You rarely see delinquents getting their just desserts on this world. I'd have talked him around eventually, but I won't say no to heavily armed assistance. Unless you can mount intelligence on a wall, I'm afraid I wouldn't be a very tempting target.
I'm on an important mission. I believe you're the man I need.
Tharin Sedrax, professor and exo-engineer, at your service. Not that many around here respect my genius, especially those Nikto. Challenge the Hutt Cartel? Where'd they get such delusions of grandeur?
I think you know the man responsible.
So Duris Fane has a vendetta against the Hutt Cartel. If any Jedi Master would risk it, Fane's the one. That's why I was right. If the Hutts find out Fane is behind this guiding hand business, it'll leave the Republic high and dry.
Master Sio said you could help me find him.
Unfortunately, it's been years since we last spoke. Joining the Nikto. You may have been onto something there. I know a local gang, the Red Light Lancers. A bunch of tech specialists and slicers of ill repute. Rumor is, they're part of this guiding hand.
How does the existence of a tech gang help me?
These Lancers have been pestering me to do a special job. I could pretend I'm interested and set up a meeting for you. But you'll need to prove your expertise. I suppose this prototype would do it, though I hate to part with it.
I'd owe you a favor.
When you put it that way. Here you are. And here, I always wear an earpiece at handover so I can call my assistant Holiday. With this, we can speak privately. Here's the location. I'll return to my office. If Fane is using some kind of mind control, I have research to do. This is Tharin Sedrax. Can you read me, Jedi?
Have the Lancers agreed to meet?
The Lancers leapt at the chance to hire me. Their boss, Klaysia, is at the meeting ground right now.
Where's Tharin Sedrax? The darkness is coming. The Lancers need the man who solved the Meraki uplink paradox, not some unplugged Jedi.
At least he can appreciate good work.
Forget this. I have to get Tharin Sedrax for the job. Master's orders.
He couldn't come. I brought my latest creation to show I'm worthy.
Impressive. But the Master said get Sedrax. Even a Jedi's no good. Bet you don't even know what a D3TR port is.
A D3TR port is used to fix computer spikes. Basic stuff, he's playing with you.
I came here in good faith, not to have my intelligence slighted.
Okay, sorry, don't bust a gimbal. So if you were gonna slice Nar Shaddaa's traffic control towers, what channel would you cut?
Any channel, I suppose. Apart from 552, too risky.
...552 is the only channel that would present a real challenge.
Seriously? Impressive. None of my people can crack cartel security. Welcome to the Red Light Lancers and the Guiding Hand, brother. Serve the Master well.
So, how can a Jedi help the Lancers and the Guiding Hand?
The Master wanted Tharan Sedrax for a special job. It'll do for your initiation test, if you live. The Hutt Cartel shares a bunch of spice factories with the Empire in the lower industrial sector. The Master wants them destroyed.
Sounds dangerous. I'll take care of it.
Go to the Defense Network Control Room and disrupt the protocols on the primary control node. That'll trigger the factory's automated defenses. Turrets, droids, poison gas, the factories and their workers will be wiped out. The Hutt Cartel will see what the Guiding Hand can do.
I suppose there's little choice in the matter.
The Hutt Cartel's an agent of the darkness. We have to stop them. I'll be monitoring the cartel's defense network, so I'll know exactly when the job is done. Don't keep us waiting.
That's a tricky proposition, Jedi. Meet me at my offices. I'll get started on a way to help you.
Oh, Tharan. What a deliciously daring idea. I'll have to watch out, in case you get any more.
Dearest Holiday, I always save my finest inspiration for you.
Pardon the interruption.
Ah, hello again. I believe I promised to help destroy those Hutt Cartel factories for the Lancers, and I found the perfect solution. A few years ago, I acquired a Sith Overseer's ID. I've modified it with the permissions to trigger those defenses, kill everyone, and bring the factories down.
I won't kill innocent factory workers. I want an alternative.
Jedi, those people make spice for the Hutt Cartel, and Klaysia won't be easy to fool.
I thought you were a genius.
There's no problem my Tharan can't solve.
I do have a resonator key, a rather rare device. Very well. Attach it to the primary control node, and Klaysia will register its signal as a network failure. The Defense Network Control Room will be near the factories in the lower industrial sector. Once you reach it, I'll help you from there. I don't envy you. That sector's a toxic nightmare, besides which there's Imperial soldiers, patrol droids, and worse.
Right there. This is an Imperial control station. I'm authorized to use deadly force protecting cartel Imperial interests. State your business or get out.
You dare impede a Sith in his duties? I should cut you down where you stand.
An inspection? I'm... Please forgive me. I meant no disrespect. Productivity is down, but we'll drive the workers harder. Double our quota next month.
The wealth of the Empire is at stake. Incompetence will be punished.
I'll see to it personally that matters improve.
You are a disgrace to the Empire. Your mere presence offends me. Leave.
Yes. Yes, my lord. At once.
Jedi, the primary control node is active. Attach that resonator key to the node. In a moment, Klaysia will think the factories are being destroyed.
Jedi, it's Klaysia. I've been monitoring the Hutt Cartel's defense network. That operation was smooth. The factories never saw it coming. You've got real talent.
Now do you believe that I'm as good as Tharan Sedrax?
Absolutely. Forget Sedrax. I should have gone after you in the first place. The Master himself has heard about you. He wants you to be presented to him in person.
The Master realizes he has a powerful new ally.
The Master's waiting at our headquarters in the Red Light Sector. It's in an old store. Here, I'll upload it to your map. Don't be long. Our fight against the Hutt Cartel is heating up, and the Master doesn't like delays.
Come, Jedi, don't keep me waiting. I've been looking forward to this ever since Klaeser mentioned his new star. Poor Klaeser. Good slicer, but he really should get out more. He's almost as out of touch as the Jedi Council. Tell me, is Seo Bacarn lightened up, or is he still the same old stuffed robe?
The plague is saying this, not you.
This plague has enlightened me. Those Jedi rules, I rarely bothered with them before, but now I see them for what they are. But I don't have the patience to explain. In fact, you've become a nuisance I need to eliminate.
The worst you can do is make me one with the Force, Master.
Then give in without a fight, like a properly stoic Jedi. I'd love to duel you myself, but the darkness is coming. Destroying the Hutt cartel demands my full attention. Kill him! I want his head when it's finished.
Can you hear me? Are you all right?
Maybe a scratch here and there, but the Force was my shield.
Can't believe Fane would do that to another Jedi.
Skocharat mas osla, svetod trangis, kundapolua, your scow open.
However, Fane may have made a mistake by using that holo transmitter. Check the holo transmitter, Jedi. Press the small switch underneath, and we'll see what can be done. I thought so. Holiday, my dear, would you oblige?
Of course. Oh my, Fane hasn't covered his tracks very well. I'll just untangle the signal.
Holiday? You're a slicer?
When I found Holiday, I discovered this enchanting woman was supported by a computer network of incredible sophistication. With so much untapped runtime, it seemed a waste not to teach her about slicing.
Found him! Fane's signal traces back to... oh... Shadowtown.
What is Shadowtown?
Shadowtown is an Imperial prison for the most dangerous prisoners in the galaxy. Well nigh impenetrable. The security there is the best on Nar Shaddaa.
The Empire wouldn't waste that much security on merely violent prisoners.
Shadowtown houses anyone the Empire needs to watch but can't control. Assassins, insane scientists, experimental specimens. Shadowtown has such exceptional security because the builders had it designed by the best minds, including myself. Come back to my offices and we'll parse the problem. I also have something to help you against Fane.
Please, I have nothing but respect for the Hutt cartel, but this is...
They say a Jedi's behind this guiding hand. We've seen a Jedi coming out of V's offices. Start talking, Cedrax.
Perhaps I could be of some assistance.
I'm with the Hutt cartel, investigating rumors that the Jedi run the Guiding Hand. Cedrax worked for them, and now here you are. I'll have to report this.
I'm just a friend of Dr. Cedrax. As for this Guiding Hand, I assure you no Jedi are involved.
Funny, because word is that a Jedi Master's behind it.
Do you have any proof of this Jedi Master, apart from rumor?
Well, no. But my contacts are normally solid, though the Hutts might be upset if this is only a rumor. Maybe I'll run my info again. But I'm watching you. Both of you.
That was too close. The Hutt cartel is closing in on Fane. Your quick wit may have allayed suspicion, but we have bigger concerns. Holiday pinpointed Fane deep in Shadowtown's residential area. There's dozens of cameras, guards, and crazed prisoners between us and him.
You handle the cameras. I'll handle the prisoners. For the guards, we can set a distraction.
I like your approach. In terms of Fane's mind control ability, I have a little something to handle that.
A little something? You're so modest, Theron.
I've been consulting with Master Sayo Bakarn, and I've built an exotech device that should prevent Fane from brainwashing us.
How can a device obstruct a Jedi's influence?
It paralyzes the part of the forebrain that's active when a Jedi tries to impose his will. It'll give Fane a short, sharp shock. Shadowtown. I never planned to see it in person. But I'm ready when you are, Jedi. Wait, Jedi. I need to scramble the Shadowtown camera uplink from here, but if the guard spots any glitches, he'll sound the alarm.
I can get the guard's attention. Just tell me for how long.
We only need a minute to muss up the camera uplink. When we're through, he won't notice the difference.
I didn't know there were Jedi prisoners here. Get back from the guard tower.
I was convicted without due process of law. Where can I argue my case?
What? You're a prisoner of the Empire. You don't get to argue anything.
You prisoners. Every day, more griping. You're lucky we don't just clean this place out.
Jedi, we're all done.
I have better things to do than argue with some Imperial drone.
Get lost before I lose my temper.
I've marked our next target on your map. We should hurry. We can cut the power to Fane's hideout here, but it's complicated. It'll take some time.
Don't worry about that. I'll protect you.
Holiday, darling. A little help?
Forgot my... You're that overseer, aren't you? Can I... Now, wait a minute. What's he doing with the power junction? Hey! You're no Sith!
You found whatever you came for. There's nobody else here. Now you're leaving.
Yes, I... Talking to myself, I must be slipping.
If we ever disagree, Jedi, please stick to a convincing argument. Fane's hideout has lost all power. Any security systems will be shut down. Sending that Imperial grunt away helped me keep my concentration. I thank you.
Don't mention it, Theron.
This is our chance. We should hurry.
Very good, Jedi. You survived both my Morgu Kai and this dank little town. Yuan Par taught you well.
Master Yuan prepared me to face anything.
Has dear Yuan ever told you about Malachor III? The truth, I mean. During our mission, we had quite the affair. She was something in the day, and her advances became irresistible.
You're trying to distract me. It won't work.
But the truth is so very important. Our passion, it paved the way for darkness to enthrall the others and destroy our friend, Parcanis Tark. That memory tormented me for years, but now I'm free. Free of guilt, free of fear.
The evil of the plague is destroying you, and you refuse to see it.
Fane, if the Hutt cartel finds out about you, the Republic's finished out here. This has to stop.
My, my. You got Theron Sedrax to care about something, Jedi. That's a gift I want on my side. Now, serve me and...
Ah! What the... What is that thing?
A little trifle of exotech. To ensure you won't be influencing my Jedi friend.
Ugh, my head. I should have known you'd bring one of your damn toys.
You've been stripped of your ability to influence me. This is over.
How dare you? You think you can challenge me?
I'll fix it.
Enough, I yield. But kill me. Kill 1,000, it doesn't matter. Lord Vivekar will never stop.
Lord Vivekar? Tell me, Vane. Who is he? Where can I find him?
Like darkness, Vivekar is everywhere. In everything.
His condition's deteriorating. We should act quickly.
Good. Fane's already down. That saves us some trouble.
Fane is in my charge. Explain what you want.
I'm an official representative of the Hutt cartel, and that man belongs to us. The guiding hand has gone too far. Jedi don't get to interfere with our business, not without consequences. Hand Fane over, or the Republic sees what unhappy Hutts can do.
Fane belongs to the Jedi, not the Hutt cartel.
If the Hutts don't get him, every Republic agent on Nar Shaddaa will find their lives suddenly complicated.
The Hutts are businessmen. What's a fair price for a Jedi Master's life?
Credits do make happy Hutts, but your master there was bad for business. It'll cost you. I guess we can negotiate with your council over the details. Okay, Fane's yours, but we will collect Jedi.
We honor our agreements. I'll ensure it personally.
I know your face. I know who to find. Goodbye.
Made a break in the darkness, but it is only momentary.
The darkness won't trouble you anymore.
I feel better. Much better. Wait, you look pale. Are you all right?
You woke me from that nightmare. I've done some terrible things, haven't I?
The plague drove you to this. You couldn't help it.
I could have, if I had been wiser. All of this. But fighting the Hutt cartel wasn't wrong. Jedi should battle evil, not appease it.
The Hutt seems satisfied. Still, you should leave Nar Shaddaa.
He's right. Accidents do happen.
Once I've freed the gang leaders, I'll return to Tython. I'm sure C.O. Bakarn is already preparing to lecture me.
Do consider listening this time, Fane. It might save you some tribulation in the future.
Maybe so. Thank you. Both of you. I owe you my sanity and my life.
Congratulations on your handling of Fane. Not to mention the Hutt cartel.
Theron, honey, someone's been calling our offices. Master Sile Bakarn of the Jedi Council, asking for our friend to call back.
Master Sio should know what happened right away.
I suppose. I should get back to my offices. Genius never takes a vacation. This was fun. Like old times with Sio and Fane. Anyway, glad I could be of assistance. Take care, Jedi.
Theron, look over there. Hey, Jedi! Yoo-hoo!
Ah, here he is, the gallant Jedi. You took your time.
I thought you two had gone back to your offices.
After our thrilling sojourn in Shadowtown, I came back to all the contracts piled up on my desk. Humdrum, tedious, boring. And I realized, Nar Shaddaa's charms have staled. I want adventure, excitement, to see something of the galaxy. So, in exchange for a single billet on your ship, you can have the tech expertise of Dr. Theron Sedrax exclusively at your disposal. What do you think?
I think that sounds like an excellent idea.
Just one thing. I call first on any exotech or lovely females we happen to encounter.
Theron, you're so naughty. I don't know why I put up with you.
Because you're a paragon of virtue and tolerance, my dear. Now, shall we go?
Report from Nar Shaddaa. The Guiding Hand has disbanded, and the Hutt Cartel has withdrawn its vendetta. Your handling of the cartel was extremely impressive. Diplomatic skill under pressure is a rare gift. Now perhaps Duras Fane can be rehabilitated.
Maybe Master Fane will be wiser after this.
He often shrugs off the lessons life gives him. With luck, this one will stick. I am glad your mission on Nar Shaddaa was a success. But now I have an urgent matter that requires your attention. We received a distress signal from the Republic's starship Corrida, and we suspect it's plague-related.
Relay me the pertinent details.
The distress call only reported a Jedi had gone insane and turned on the crew. Of particular interest, the Jedi in question is Lorana Fane, Master Duras Fane's daughter. Fane is on his way back to Tython, but I've asked him to join us over Holo. I thought he should be kept informed.
I should hope so, Sile. Being a Jedi doesn't stop me from caring about my own daughter.
Do you think the plague is spread through families?
No, but this can't be a coincidence either. Vivekar chooses his targets for a reason. You will dock in the ship's forward section, where Lieutenant Bella Wynn and her men have managed to find safety. Find Lorana Fane. Shield her if you can and see what you can learn. Go with care.
I never thought I'd say it, but good riddance to Nar Shaddaa. Nobody on that wretched moon has a speck of imagination. Take my little business. If I wasn't building devices to cheat the casinos, I was being nagged for new weapons.
So being sought out and admired for creating wonders of technology, that meant nothing to you?
Well, I suppose there were compensations.
Now, we get to travel in the most darling ship. Although, I can't bear your ship's computer architecture. It's so frumpy. Mind if I give it a little flair?
Will this flair interfere with it being completely operational?
No. Don't you worry about a thing.
Holiday has quite the talent for making herself at home. Better leave her to it. So, lead on, Jedi. Just one moment, Jedi. Holiday's latest viral safeguards need to upload. Quite a weighty update this week.
Someone's been busy. I should give this my full attention. Good night.
Ah, Holiday. You are unique indeed.
You and Holiday clearly care for each other.
Naturally. She's proof that science and beauty can coexist. Her former owner never appreciated Holiday's potential. That's a hut for you.
Holiday's last owner was a hut, then.
Glorzo, his name was. He collected rare technology, but he thought Holiday was just a novelty hologram. Imagine. I made a generous offer, but some scavenger had already struck a deal for her. So, Glorzo saw the chance for a little fun.
You make a good living. How could a simple scavenger compete with your funds?
I was between clients, and Hata has expensive diversions. Glorzo proposed a contest. The scavenger and I would head into the Val asteroid field, hopefully surviving more than 2 minutes. The first to bring back a stone from the Rukabi Major asteroid would win Dear Holiday.
I hear approaching Rukabi Major is suicidal. There's too much debris around it.
I had the last laugh. Clever piloting is no match for knowing certain navigational algorithms. I got the stone, returned days before the scavenger, and exchanged it for Sweet Holiday.
So you heroically rescued Holiday from the grip of a cruel hut and won her heart.
Someday it'll make an excellent Hollow novel. Ah, but what's the past to the present? And we have things to do.
Hold your fire, men! Hold your fire! It's the Jedi the Council sent. Sorry, Jedi. We're all a little on edge.
I understand. You have every right to be on edge.
Thanks. We've contained Lorana, but I don't know what to do. She was a great passenger at first. Happy, smart, interested in the ship. But then we were hit by an Imperial ambush. Lorana fought them off, almost died from her wounds. After a day or so, she started talking strange, and then the slaughter.
What was she saying that seemed odd?
Always the same thing. Darkness. The darkness is coming. But wait, that started later. After the ambush, we put out a call for medical assistance, and a Jedi Master answered. He healed her right up. He was odd, though. Had these horrible scars he kept covering. Never said his name. You know, Lorana was different after he left.
Other Jedi are suffering from a similar illness. He could have given it to her.
I don't think so. He healed her. She's as strong as ever. Stronger, even. It was a struggle, but we managed to trap her in the aft section. If I can just...
Lieutenant Wynn, Lorana's slicing into the Carida systems. She's taking over the whole ship. She'll start shutting down life support soon.
No! Jedi, please! You're the only one who stands a chance of stopping her! Do whatever you have to. Just don't let Lorana kill any more of my men.
I won't let you down.
Thank you. I'll release the lockdown for a moment to let you in, but I won't risk Lorana getting out. There's a comm device back there. Contact me when you've taken care of her, and I'll release the lockdown again so you can leave. Good luck.
What have we here? A little engineer poking around where he shouldn't. I wonder what this button does. Was that the airlock? Silly me. Bye-bye, little engineer.
Lord Duras Vane's daughter, Lorana.
Lorana Vane? Why, yes, that's me. How did you guess? The ship is nearly under my control. Isn't it wonderful? The darkness is coming, but it won't take me.
We can stop the darkness together. Just listen to me first.
I won't be fooled. You belong to the darkness. Lord Vivekar explained everything when he healed me. But you're not going to kill me, Jedi. I won't let you.
Clearly you haven't heard of us.
I won't let the darkness take me. Go away or I'll open the airlock. I'd rather die than be taken.
You don't want to release the airlock. You want to come to me.
I want to come to you. I won't release the airlock. Take my lightsaber. Please don't let me hurt anyone else.
Don't worry, Lorana. Everything's going to be all right.
What did you do? You look so weak. But Lord Vivekar's voice is gone. The voice in my head. How did you do it?
A shielding ritual that blocks Vivekar's influence. The same ritual that saved your father.
But it's taken a lot out of you. And the difference for me, it's like night and day. I just can't believe I let that monster make me do those terrible things. I'm sorry. I'm going to lock myself in the brig until we reach a port. I don't trust myself.
Merely a scratch.
Lorana, my child, my Jedi. So, you have robbed me of a most promising student. As if that will delay the inevitable. You Jedi are an endless source of amusement.
We meet at last, Plague Master.
You know nothing of me. But I know all about your order. Once, I served the Jedi Council blindly, as you do. There is no emotion, only peace. I believed, but the teachings of the Dark Lord Terek Morridge showed me the error of my ways. Thousands of years ago, Morridge's hatred nearly crushed the Jedi. That is true power.
I already know how to stop the plague.
You mean your shielding technique? The Jedi do love repeating their mistakes. You know how the originator of that technique died, don't you? He sacrificed too much of himself and perished nameless. Everyone I have ever touched could fall to this plague. You cannot shield them all.
What if I use my shielding technique on you?
My power is already beyond your comprehension, and every moment makes me stronger. You are too late. I've already won.
Restored Lorana Fade to the light. She's in the brig and won't cause any harm.
Are you sure, Jedi? I mean,
She killed a lot of my people.
You're perfectly safe.
I trust you. You saved our lives, and if Lorana's in the brig, she should be secure there. I'll report back to Master CO immediately. You should do the same. Once we get the ship back under control, we'll set a course for Coruscant. Thank you for everything, Jedi.
I've just received Bellowin's report. I'm so glad Lorana Fane is shielded and well.
Thank you for my daughter's life. I have to go to her.
Did you manage to learn anything more about Lord Vivekar, the Plague Master?
He needs to touch his victims in order to spread the plague.
I'm listening. So this scarred man who healed Lorana Fane is Lord Vivekar. Amazing work, Jedi. Still no leads on how to find him, but we do know more about his plague.
What happens now?
I wish I had better news, but the situation has worsened. Two more Jedi Masters have now gone silent. In their last transmissions, both Masters said, "The darkness is coming." One Master was on Alderaan, the second on Tatooine. You must go to these worlds and investigate, quickly.
I will do everything in my power to help.
Thank you. I know you will. May the Force be with you on Tatooine and Alderaan. Good luck.
Ah, excellent. We have a mystery. A package was hand-delivered to the ship. No name, aside from mine. No return address. The package contained a letter on flimsyplast, sealed inside a glass capsule. Nothing else.
That's simply fascinating.
The capsule has a marvelously puzzling lock. I've never seen such craftsmanship. Once I get it open and read the letter, hopefully I can assuage my curiosity.
This is so exciting! I wonder who it's from.
Tharren's technological work is famous. Perhaps someone is trying to get his attention.
I'll get to work on this lock. If you're right, we'll know soon enough.